on the wrong hero. I'm the hero of Central Square. I hate everybody, and everybody hates me. I'm always in the wrong place at the wrong time, and everything I do is wrong. And I'm going to tell you what I really hate. Time Magazine. Who elected these people anyway? What are they, the fifth branch of government always telling us what to do? The man of the year. The man of the year? Since when do these guys get to pick who the man of the year is going to be? And I'll tell you who else I really hate. Boris Yeltsin. This is the man that's supposed to save Russia? His hair looks like cotton candy spun out of dried snot. I hate this magazine. What is this, the Honda Accord? What were they doing, sitting around deciding on what to call a car? Let's call it Cougar. No, let's call it Moose. No, let's call it Honda. It sounds like the car that Little Red Riding Hood drives. What's going on here anyway? What are happening to cars with manly names like Killer and Stalker and Destroyer? I hate these ads. They really bug the hell out of me. That's because this woman had to pose in the afternoon with all that dark lighting because she couldn't stop coughing until then. I hate these ads. I'll tell you what else I hate. Actually, I kind of like this. America's Ugliest Home Videos. That's where I'm at, because I'm the wrong hero. I don't like to help people, I like to hurt them. Because I'm always in the wrong place at the wrong time. And everything I do is wrong. And this is what I really hate. Snoopy. Snoopy, this miserable mutt. He'd sell them stinking birds just to make a big hit on television. He'd sell his own mother just so he could appear in an ad for MetLife. What does a beagle know about selling life insurance? And I tell you one more thing I really hate. Schaefer beer. The one beer to have when you're an alcoholic, right? This is Cafe Cabaret at the Middle East.
Stancourt. First time I was up here, I played my anti-war song that worked. And I played my anti-love song that worked. And then the following week, I played my anti-audience song. That seemed to have worked. Tonight, I'm actually going to play a love song. This is for a friend of mine who, she hadn't come into my life, I might not be here tonight. It's Julia. It's called Snow White.
She was always there, in my darkness and despair, in the blackest of my blackest nights, greatest of my doubts. When life wasn't fair, she let me know she cared. She held my hand and dried my tears and calmed the raging storm. She's my snow white lady, come to me from up above. She taught me how to live and she taught me how to love. When I'm feeling grumpy, sleepy, don't be bashful too. She sure makes me happy when she whispers I love you. Drunk my share of booze, I had nothing left to lose. You see, I'd lost my wife, my kids, my home, had nothing left to pay. One only just to die. Sometimes Sometimes I wonder why. Every time I knock me down, this lady filled me up again. She's my snow white lady, come to me from up above. She taught me how to live and she taught me how to love. When I'm feeling grumpy, sleepy, dopey, bashful too, she sure makes me happy when she whispers I love you. Well, she came into my life amid turbulence and strife, and she propped me up when I was weak and helped to make me strong. And lady sure surprised me. She reached down deep inside me and she found a man I didn't know was in me all alone. She's my snow white lady, come to me from up above. She taught me how to live and then she taught me how to love. When I'm feeling grumpy, sleepy, dopey, bashful too, she sure makes me happy when she whispers I love you. Yeah, she sure makes me happy when she whispers I love you.
Next song is one that I put together, and I hate to admit it, but 20 years ago. I took a poem I came across written by an anonymous addict, set it to music, and I've been playing it for 20 years. It was probably the only song that I've been playing for 20 years that I haven't gotten tired of yet. Unfortunately, the message is still as pertinent today as it was 20 years ago. The name of the piece is Miss Harold. So now, little man, you've grown tired of grass, careless, deep, false, cocaine, and
you realize the monster you have grown. You solemnly promise to leave me alone. If you think that you've got some kind of mystical knack, sweetie, just try. Get me off your back.
Get
same old man sitting there on his own and looking at the world over the rim of the teacup. Each day lasts an hour and he wanders home alone. Don't shine. Let me take you by the hand and lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something there to make you change your mind. I'll show you something there to make you change your mind.
April 22nd. Where, Bill Stancourt?
Kendall Cafe. Kendall Cafe in Kendall Square.
It's with or without your group, running the station?
This is by myself, a solo thing, although some of the members from the band will be popping in, just kind of guest appearances. As a matter of fact, I just managed to line up tonight how the Acoustics to open for me. So.
Talk about networking.
Great.
That was Gil Stancourt of Huntington Station, not to be confused with Bronzeville Station. Here's Derrick Feather. Let's give him a hand. Come on.
This is a song, anyway, which I wrote about a book written by Ursula Le Guin about a wizard. Thank you. was going to do something else, but after hearing Streets of London, for some reason it inspired me to do this one. I'm not quite sure why. I guess it's a very sad song. This one, anyway, is one of the most pointlessly sad songs I've ever heard, written by Richard Thompson, called Crazy Man Michael. Within the fire and up on the sea, Crazy Man Michael's walking. He met with a raven with eyes black as coals, and shortly they fell to talking. Your future, I would tell to you. Your future, you often have asked me. True love will die by your own right hand. And Crazy Man Michael, he cursed me. Michael, he ranted, and Michael, he raved, and beat at the four winds with his fist toe. He laughed and he cried, he shouted and he swore, for his mad mind attracted him the kiss so. He speak with an evil, he speak with a hate, he speak for the devil that haunts me. For is she not the fairest in all the world? Your sorcerer's words are to taunt me. He took up his dagger of fire and of steel, and struck down the raven in the heart of the bird fluttered long, and the sky did spin, and the cold earth did wonder and startled. Oh, where is the raven that I struck down dead? Here did lie on the ground, oh, for I see that my true love with a wound so red, where her lover's heart it did pound, oh. Crazy Man Michael, he wanders and looks, and he talks to the night and the day, oh. But his eyes, they are sane, and his speech it is plain, and he longs to be far away. Oh, Michael, he whistles the simplest tunes and asks the wild wolves that haunt him, for his true love is flown into every flower grown, and he must be keeper of the garden. La 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 la
you.
Thank you, Derrick.
That was Derrick. Let's give him another hand.
Don't you is us, you love it. Don't pretend like, oh, for me? No, it was really great. Thanks a lot, Derrick. Now we have Josie Packard. Let's give her a hand.
Thank you.
Josie, last week you were so good that everybody was singing your praises, but I think this week you've excelled yourself. Let's give another hand, Josie. I quit. So, in light of this fact, I think I better bring on our resident funny man, Mr. Charlie Kvaaks.
They look at me and go, "You were on Carson Beach? When? You know? You familiar with Carson Beach? No. South Boston? No, you never leave Cambridge, right? So, you people all musicians here or what? You getting ready to play? That's cool. I bought a garage door opener for my car, and I got this stupid remote. It must have been a malfunction because when I turned it on, my fly was going up and down all day. Yeah, it was really weird. Called phone sex up. Anyone here try phone sex yet? I'll tell you, I called phone sex up the other day. I got an earache. I gotta tell you, I've been watching the movies a lot. Have you people seen this America's Gladiator show? Anyone watch this show here on TV? Yeah, isn't that some show, huh? I got the wrong show. I guess American Gay Gladiators was on. These guys were fighting with Q-tips, you know, punching each other. Yeah, that was hysterical. You kidding? That was. I mean, that's one of my best lines. That gets a laugh. I'll tell you,
it's favorite, all right?
Yeah, I know. I've been. I work. I drive a truck in Cambridge. Do you work in Cambridge? Or?
No.
You just hang here.
Yeah.
So what else has been happening? I got stopped by the NBC cops the other day. I've been trying to cut down drinking, you know, so, you know, they pulled me over and they asked me for my license and everything. They said, now we're going to give you an alcohol test. So I picked up the beer they had and I says, you know, I drank it. I said, this stuff sucks. You got anything better than this? You know, yeah, that's a good one. You like that one? So, Jesus Christ, I haven't seen a place with so many bikes here. What's going on here? Is that, you got a trio here playing tonight? Any hockey fans here tonight? Any hockey fans here? Anyone play hockey here? No. Some friends of mine, they always want me to come out and play hockey with them, but I don't know about that because, they get ice time at like 3 o'clock in the morning. And at 3 o'clock in the morning, I'm kind of slapping my own hockey stick, you know? But it's sort of like guaranteed to score then, you know? Been working out a lot. I've been playing a lot of racquetball. Any people here play racquetball? Racquetball. I play racquetball.
Yeah,
great. I play racquetball with this friend of mine. I tell you, the guy's enormous. He's really big. You know, every time I get the ball off the back wall, I sort of hit him in the back. You know, because he's really big. As a matter of fact, I'm getting ready to paint his back white and put a red line across so I can have a simulated wall there. You know. Do you ever get these guys in the health club that know it all? They're trying to tell you what to do all the time. You know, like they look at you and they go, "Hey, pal, you know you're doing that all wrong." I said, "Is that right?" You know, this guy looks like Bonnie Fife, soaking wet. You know, he's trying to give me a tip on doing some exercises. So I look at him, I say, "Pal, let me give you a tip. You want to go to the director of this facility and show him your body?" He said, "Yeah, why is that?" I said, "Because he might give you your money back, you know?" Yeah. And he looks at me in the shower after. He's kind of big, you know, and he says, "Charlie, you notice anything different about me?" I says, he looks at me and says, "Yeah, you know, my stomach's going down." I said, "Yeah, down to your balls, you know?" So... okay, that's about all the stuff I want to try out here tonight. You've been a crowd. I'll tell you, it's real nice. But next week, if you people like me, okay, hey, listen, don't, you shouldn't be talking, comics. You know, come on, you guys, girls. You know, that's not nice. Well, when you're up here, I want to do that to you. You know, are you getting up here tonight? Because I want to stick around and see this act, really. Okay, I'm going to turn this back on to your host, Francis DiMenno. Give him another hand, y'all. Well, all these guys coming together, the people over here. Thank you.
Thank you. Nice job.
It's DiMenno. Oh, kill. Charlie Kvaaks. Hey, Charlie, where are you playing again?
Where's that? Big Comedy Monday night, Bentley's Tuesday night.
What are you going to do, Dana's down in West Warwick? Well, listen, I want you all to promise that when Charlie does get around to doing Dana's, that prestigious hot spot down in West Warwick, Rhode Island, we'll all charter a bus, right? We'll go down here, we'll be at the cheering section, and at the end, they'll slip us $10, you know? They'll be really impressed. And we'll make Charlie happy, we'll make us happy because we made Charlie happy. Let's give him another hand, Charlie Kvaaks. Well, now I'd like to bring up our most distinguished guest. He hasn't told me his last name yet, but a man this talented doesn't have to have a last name. Let's just call him Al.
To linger by my side, I whispered in her ear, I think I love. next song is a fiction song about a man that was the first one on the earth.
Al. 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 Al.
Can we get an Al chant going?
good. I think next we have, but I have to ask her about her name. I can't resist. Lara Schuler. It's spelled L-A-R-A. Is that, that's Supergirl's name, you know? Was that a conscious decision on your mother's part? Is she a big fan? I was just curious. I'm not making fun of your name, honest. I mean, Francis, you know. I can't really talk. Frankie. That's what my sister calls her. Frankie. What do you? Oh, Frankie. She wrote one of her letters. Well, anyway. All of Josh on the side. Lara Schuler.
I've heard you calling out my name.
That was Lara Schuler. Do you have anything on your mind? Empty. Oh well. I knew he wouldn't show up, but let's bring up Bobby Optimism if he's here. Oh, I knew he wouldn't show up. Knew it. Bobby?
There he is. Wow. Let's give it a hand for Bobby Optimism.
So, how are you doing tonight?
Good.
How? Anybody go see the Doors movie yet?
No.
Not yet? Originally, the movie was supposed to have John Travolta playing the part of Jimbo. Mascara, and then he walked into his brother's room, and then he walked on down the hall. Father, yes, son, can I borrow the car and $50? Mother, I want to do the hustle all night long. Has anybody seen the sequel of Dances with Wolves? Slam Dances with Penguins? Starring Sinead O'Connor as what else? A bald-headed angry punk? There's a pivotal scene where she meets the chief of the people who live in this region where all the penguins are. So, I'll demonstrate the scene for you.
Oh, it's so cold, I wish I had shoes. Oh, it's so cold, I
That's why Sinead's angry. let's see, there's a new horror film coming out that I like. It's not number one, number two, but just when you thought it was safe to go into the cafeteria and buy a candy bar, Vending Machine 3 from Dust of the Gods! Ah! No, it's got my hand! Ah! Yes, it was an innocent-looking candy machine standing outside of the Pentagon War Room door. And there comes General Schwarzkopf, played by Willard Scott. He said, I'm a man who this could change the future of the world.
Give me the name of a movie that's coming out. I didn't even make one up.
Silence?
No, you gotta make one up.
Why?
Alright, Silence of the Lambs. This is a real sad story about a mute lamb who wants only to be able to become a folk singer. She tries really hard to cross her four legs and balance her guitar. Mary had a little lamb, me. Mary had a little lamb, it was me. Oh, ching, 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 ching. Ching, 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 ching. Someday a butcher will turn me into lamb chops. Ching, 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 ching. How about something else?
George Bush meets Gandhi.
George Bush meets Gandhi.
Well, I wish he wasn't dead. We can learn. Peace. Gandhi? Gandhi? If you were alive, what would you say? A little more than that, please. Okay. Okay, so we're not doing the talk thing. Okay. Well, we're not going to do the talk thing. Then, I guess we'll have to fight. All I wanted was a word. We wouldn't have invaded India, but Gandhi wouldn't speak. We had to attack. I asked, there was peace, there was a chance. I asked, he wouldn't take it. We had war, thank you.
George and Saddam's excellent adventure.
George and Saddam's
excellent adventure. Rose Saddam, I like the way you fly the plane, fly the plane, fly the plane, fly the plane. George, I like the way you co-pilot, 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 co-pilot. Where are we gonna go? I don't know, but let's make it adventurous. Let's go to Paris and have some French toast. That doesn't sound too exciting to me, Mr. Bush.
Rocky does bowl
Winko.
Come here, you little moose. I'll give you a goose. You sexy moose. Now sit on my lap, but don't take a crap. You're my favorite moose. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. I really like you, Bowinko.
Married to the Godfather.
Married to the Godfather?
Got me an orange. Do it quicker, I'm gonna die very soon. All this time I just wanted to bring the little love and money to my family. You know, it's not easy murdering so many people. I must die now. Well, one more movie and then I'm gonna take intermission.
General Schwarzkopf does Dallas.
We've got a lot of doing movies here. Okay. Schwarzkopf does Dallas. Good people of Dallas. Patriotic. I care about the people of Dallas. You know how hard it is being in Dallas and being somebody from Dallas? But they had to be Dallas, because they're from Texas, and that's what I like about them. They're really good. Well, I just want to tell you about my job before I leave. I just got a new job. I didn't think I would like it at first. I'm raising fungus, but I find it really grows on you.
Bobby, Optimism. That is horrible pain. How'd that get there?
Jeez.
Try to kick myself in the ass and I missed. Let's bring up Howie Acoustics.
Smiling into my next song is called Kid Fears.
Give him another hand. I ruin everything. This.
That's why I gave you your old special one, Francis, because you were doing everything.
Old scratchy here, huh? You are my own special mic. No, I don't think so. I think actually what I'm going to do at this juncture is introduce, all the way from the great state of Maine, Mr. Ray Sisti.
Thank you! This song's about a friendship, a relationship.
Talked a little while to
face staring in the background. It felt good to give my last rose away to someone who didn't expect it on Valentine's Day.
Who needs flea markets? I hate them. and I hate McDonald's. You know why kids love McDonald's? Immediate gratification! They go in there and they order the food and they get it right away, bam! That's a great lesson for them! Just stick up a bag if they need money. Immediate gratification, I hate McDonald's. But I'll tell you who I like. I like my mom. I like my mom. Mother's Day is coming up. I don't know when, but it is. You know what I say to my mom? I say, Mom, if you don't spend all day in the kitchen making food, just dripping with saturated fat, I just might think that you don't really love me. You know what happened on St. Patrick's Day? A gang of unruly Irish youth rioted outside of a showing of Finnegan's Rainbow. I got some words of wisdom for you. Always eat lots of aspirin before you start drinking, because the aspirin makes the booze act faster. A fool and his money ought to come over here. Oh, remember that situation? After I take his money, he will have learned a valuable lesson. Time is a great healer. But if you do me dirt, my fists are going to introduce you to plastic surgery, all right? He who laughs last is standing there like an idiot, laughing, laughing, when there's important work to be done. I'm the wrong hero, and I got more important things to do than to stand around and talk to you, a bunch of would-be, scrubby, penis, boho assholes. I hate you all because you're evil. We're gonna do a 3-minute song. What song you got for us today?
I need you. You really
like that. I need you by the Arrhythmics. Oh, boy.
Wrong hero.
Callie, this was worth coming down to Maine to see, I'm telling you.
Wrong hero.
One, two. Fuck you. My mom is not here tonight, I can swear. This is Jeffrey and JD, where are you, man? I'm places. Sorry.
Travel and chapter. You might be happy to know the wrong hero has his own network now.
Yeah! Hero! Wrong!
And the debut show is going to be Sunday, opposite Married with Children. And it's going to be called Couch. And it's about a couch. It doesn't play ball, it doesn't jump around, it just sits there. Thanks for coming out to Cafe Cabaret. We hope to see you next week. Our stellar guests, far too many to name by individual name, but let me give a special thanks to Al, Traveling Chapter, Highway Acoustics, Ray Sisti, Come Down Away from Maine, and anybody else I left out, like Jill Stancourt. Please don't be offended or anything like that. And Lara, yes, Lara with the Supergirl name. And last but not least, Josie Packard. Let's give them all a big hand. See you next week. Monkey Mind up tonight. I'll be coming around to collect the money, by the way, if you're sick.